Yo, what's up? Dr. Swole here, MD bodybuilder, back with another video in my basics of training series. Today, I'm going to be walking you through how to write a full body program for 3 days in the gym per week. I'm really pleased to be showing you this program because this is what I actually prescribe to most beginner and intermediate athletes. And I think that going through the process of writing this program with you is going to show you a lot about how I incorporate these scientific recommendations that I've been talking about throughout this series in a real life program. As we talked about in our frequency video, I think that if you're in the gym 3 days per week, a full body split or some modified full body split is probably the best way to go. This makes sure that we're hitting our muscle groups at least 2 times per week, according to our frequency recommendation. I think a lot of you will benefit from this style of training program, and even advanced bodybuilders, at least natural ones, often only need 3 to 4 days of training per week to reach their genetic potential. So if you're ready to learn, let's begin. So again, we've got our 8 muscle groups, and this time in terms of sets per week, we've bumped up the volume since we have more days to train, and we're centered more around 10 sets per week per muscle group, which is at the lower end of the ideal range of 10 to 20 sets, as I mentioned in my volume video. Now, I've written this in a very simple way in that I take the number of sets per week and simply divide it by 3. Doing 12 sets per week for a certain muscle group means 4 sets per workout. Now note, at this point, we're going to be starting to introduce some variation in the rep ranges that we're using to satisfy our recommendation from our rep ranges video. That is, we'll keep 2/3 of our volume in the 6 to 12 rep range, but we're going to actually have 1/3 of that volume outside of that rep range. So to go through how we do this for each muscle group, starting off with quads, you're going to be back squatting on days 1 and day 3. And on day 1, you're going to be doing 4 sets of 5, which is below our 6 to 12 rep range and will help you develop strength. Now, on day 2, I've introduced leg presses. Now, in terms of assigning the different rep ranges to different exercises, a rough way I like to look at it is that you divide exercises into either multi-joint free weight movements, like the back squat, multi-joint machine movements, which the leg press is an example of, and single-joint isolation movements, like the leg extension. The multi-joint free weight movements tend to work better in lower rep ranges, like 8 reps and below. The multi-joint machine movements tend to work in a slightly higher rep range, more like 8 to 12 reps. And isolation movements tend to work better in higher rep ranges, like 10 reps or more. So wrapping up quads on day 3, back squats again, we're still going to be doing back squats 2x per week, which I think will help with your technical development and strength. Moving on to our hamstrings and glutes, we've still got deadlifts 3x5 in the middle, which will be your main strength builder. Then we've got RDLs on day 3 still, and here we introduce leg curls, an isolation movement on day 1. For chest, we're still doing bench press 2x per week, but we've got the sets of 5 on day 1 for strength development, and dumbbell bench press in the middle. For back, we're going to be doing barbell rows and weighted chin-ups on day 1 and day 3. And on day 2, we've got single arm dumbbell rows, this time in the 12 to 15 rep range, which is our allocation of volume that's outside of the 6 to 12 rep range. Now, in cases where you have to choose between a horizontal row and a vertical row, I would generally split those evenly throughout a program. However, if you're going to do more of one, I would generally lean towards the horizontal row. Horizontal rows tend to involve a little bit more of the back musculature, bringing in a little bit more rhomboid and trap. For shoulders, we've got overhead press on day 1. Note that this is a multi-joint free weight movement, and we're going to program it in a slightly lower rep range, 6 to 10. Then we've got lateral raises. This is an isolation movement, so we're going to program in higher rep ranges. We'll use lateral raises for our outside the 6 to 12 rep range volume, and then we're going to go to upright rows on day 3. For shoulders, I would generally recommend having some type of overhead pressing to get at your anterior delts, and then making sure you have some lateral raise type movements for your side delts. For biceps, we're going to do barbell curls, cable curls, and dumbbell curls, and we'll do 1/3 of our volume outside the 6 to 12 rep range on day 2 here. For triceps, we've got cable press downs, close grip bench presses, which I'm going to program in a lower rep range here, 5 to 8, and skull crushers on day 3. And lastly, for calves, we've got
standing and machine calf raises. Now, in terms of differences between the 2 days a week and 3 days a week programs, the 3 days per week program sees some introduction of isolation type and machine work. Still, there is a focus on heavy compound movements that we emphasized in our exercise selection video. I would introduce more single joint work in a 4 days or more type program. You'll see that I've changed up the rep ranges on the different workout days. This is called daily undulating periodization, and it's a method of switching up the rep ranges on different days, which has been shown in a few studies to lead to better strength gains.
All right, just a few more things to wrap up here. In terms of relative intensity, I would suggest training to 1 to 2 reps shy of failure, as we talked about in our intensity video. The other thing is that when writing a full body program, you should think of each of those 8 muscle groups as having its own separate program. This is because different muscle groups respond differently depending on the person. Thus, you should be modifying the number of sets, rep ranges, and exercise you do for each muscle group in order to allow you to progress optimally. For example, right now in my training program, I actually do 21 sets of back training per week, but I only do 7 sets of hamstring work. In terms of exercise selection, keep in mind that this program right now is on the lower end of our recommended range of volume, hitting about 10 sets per muscle group per week. As such, you should probably be keeping most of your training in heavy compound movements. What I mean is that when you modify this program, as I've just told you to, you shouldn't be swapping deadlifts for, say, leg curls, but you might swap them for something like a hip thrust. Now, you also might be wondering why there's no direct ab or trap work in this program. This is contentious in bodybuilding, but a lot of competitive bodybuilders have found that they don't need to train their abs or traps directly because these muscles get a lot of stimulation from heavy compound movements. That's all for now, guys. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe, like the video, and leave me a comment below. Let me know if you found this 3 days per week program helpful. See you next time.